on Scottish.
Don't Forget Your Toothbrush 2 is on 4. Here on Scottish, leading us up to our movie Silver Streak, we join Jim Rosenthal for Big Fight Live.
Frank Bruno is a man on a mission. He's made his pile, but he's still a dedicated, hungry fighter, driven on by his desire to be world champion. Bruno's trained harder than ever.
I think it's his destiny to become a world champion. It's his dream, and it's his wish for this year, you know, and I think he's got a great chance.
Tonight, he must beat the Puerto Rican Rodolfo Marin. He's 16 and a half stones. He stands between Bruno and another crack at the world title. Marine's record is very respectable. 20 wins from 23 fights.
The guy's had 23 fights and he's knocked out 16 of them, and he hasn't knocked out 16 of them like lifting up his armpits, and he ain't washed for about a year or that. He's knocked them out of his hands. So you've got to respect that.
Bruno, at 33, is still one of Britain's best loved sportsmen. He just loves making people happy. This year, he's motivated by a professional and a very personal dream.
Oliver McCall, that's my main aim for 95. My wife to have a boy, he was pregnant, you know, expecting the baby in March, and me to be heavyweight champion of the world in 95.
ITV Sport and Frank Bruno combined to bring professional boxing to Shepton Mallet in Somerset for the very first time. We're at the Royal Bath and West of England showground, and it is absolutely packed. Hello, a very good evening to all. Frank Bruno is an immaculate sporting role model, and he knows more than anyone. Millions of you are joining us now here on ITV, hoping that Frank gets into the ring, gets the job done, and emerges unscathed. For those of you worried about his safety, I can assure you, Frank comes here in immaculate condition, and he's his heaviest ever as well. And at the age of 33, well, he's really a pup in modern heavyweight terms. Alongside me, Barry McGuigan. Barry, you know how Frank feels trying to win the world title. Is that a realistic dream for him?
Well, we have yet to know whether it's going to be a realistic dream or not. But it's the one trophy that's always eluded him. He's had three attempts at it. He desperately wants to win it. He's 33 years old, but he's got the body on him like a 20-year-old. And he really has the right attitude too.
And physically at 33, I mean, he's heavier than ever. He looks stronger than ever as well.
Yeah, he's heavier. He's grown. He's filling out. And, yeah, he's in tremendous condition. That's one thing that he's always had, fabulous condition. And he'll be in tremendous shape tonight. And I feel this opponent is pretty innocuous. So he'll not have any trouble disposing of him.
OK, well, we shall wait and see. As you can probably hear, we've got a fantastically enthusiastic crowd here in Shepton Mallet. I reckon they could have sold this arena three times over. As it is, there are more than 5,000 people inside. The promoter who brought the fight here is Frank Warren. He's down at ringside chatting to Gary Newborn.
Well, I'm going to ask Frank in just a moment, Jim, just how good is Bruno's opponent? Because nobody down here is really sure, and certainly Marlene looked very nervous at the weigh-in, but wouldn't you if you're giving 13 pounds away? Frank Warren, just how difficult has it been to find Big Frank an opponent?
Well, we tried to get him somebody out of the top 10. We've tried very hard to get Joe Hip, the guy who beat Marin. But it's very difficult. Nobody wants to give up position at the moment because of this situation with Mike Tyson coming out of prison, and there's other guys who've got world titles, so they're looking for very big payday, so that was a problem. So then we looked at another couple, and the best we could come up with was Marin. Marin's got a fair record. He's had 23 fights, he's lost three, he's only ever been stopped once, and that was by Riddick Bowe, and he's got his jaw broken two places, so, and Riddick Bowe, as we all know, is a puncher.
Okay, let's just have a look at the sizes. I mean, he's got a big job here, hasn't he, the opponent?
Well, he's a big guy, he's a heavyweight. He's knocked 16 out himself, so he obviously can bang. And that's the heaviest I think Frank Bruno's ever been in his career.
They love him here, don't they?
They certainly do. I wish we'd got a bigger venue. We could have sold it out twice over easily.
Okay, back to you, Jim.
Thanks very much indeed, Gary. Well, it's always interesting to have a peep at the boxers inside their dressing rooms. And as we look down there, well, that's Rodolfo Marin. Bit of a minder in his spare time. First fight in Britain. Doesn't speak a lot of English. He knows his way around the ring and he can hit, given the chance. Frank Bruno, well, he's been laughing and joking throughout, but he's now very serious. And he's getting ready, as he says, to get down to business. And we'll be back with a showdown at the showground in a couple of minutes.
Kevin has a very sore throat.
I've got a very sore throat.
He's tried almost everything, but here's something from Vicks, so different it'll start to work before this commercial ends. It's ultra-chloraseptic with benzocaine. Its unique direct-action nozzle means that it can get right to where it hurts right away.
But could its fast-acting painkiller work
before this commercial ends?
Trust Vicks to help you feel better.
Fast.
Libra from Vauxhall, the most aerodynamic production coupe on Earth.
Newspaper tomorrow, one woman's terrifying account of her abduction by aliens, her horrifying assault, and her nightmare experience at the hands of creatures from another planet. Only one paper would dare bring you this story. The People Paper.
Got it quiet tonight, huh, Gino?
In a buffalo d'acqua.
Don Franco.
You better ring the Royal.
No need, Don Franco. He's just a scratch.
I'm not talking about the car.
For all types of insurance, for all kinds of mishaps, you better ring the Royal.
Again from Shepton Mallet. One man in the ring, it's your MC for tonight, Mike Goodall.
Thank you.
please welcome back into the arena Britain's very own Frank Bruno.
From London, he has a professional record
losses, 36 wins coming by way of KO. He weighed in today at 17 stone 8 and 3/4 pounds. He is the former ABA champion and was the former undefeated European heavyweight champion and 3 times world challenger, ladies and gentlemen, Frank Bruno.
Bruno is back. Let's see how he does with your big fight commentators, Jim Watt. And first of all, a very good evening to Reggie Guttridge.
Yes, Jim, the appropriate site this on an agricultural showground for this beef trust show. Only one round, remember, in the last 6 months, and Bruno might be just got a bit ring rusty. But as always, he's as physically mean as a butcher's dog, really, muscles on his ears. He's calling it his last chance saloon and Custer's last stand. I bet he thinks Don King had the stand right next to it. Well, it all depends really on the strength or lack of it with the Puerto Rican. But the American thick ear traders, well, they say Marinas doesn't fall over, he needs knocking over. Jim Watt and I have seen him in preliminary bouts, and Jim Watt seems to remember him more than I do. That was too tight for the show. We'll talk about that later on. But don't blink, put the kettle on, because Bruno's had 12 first round knockouts. But I agree with the general opinion in the States that this fellow is a wary type of fighter and he'll need knocking over. Doubtfully he'll fall.
Seemed to land in the temple. It was a decent punch, Reg.
Yeah, that one wasn't, Jim. He missed by a mile with that. It's a little bit wild.
Already Bruno's jabbed, giving him some trouble.
Yeah, just turned that into a left hook. This fellow's not going to come up, Jim. He's not going to make it. Well, I make that about 60 seconds. And a lot of fuss, and he's done it again, Bruno. Now, the trouble was, Jim, you'd seen him before on some Tyson bills. What do you remember about Marine?
I remember he was a decent fighter, well-schooled, but he didn't do anything particularly well. He's obviously come over here at the tail end of a career. He never got a world title shot. He knows he's probably never going to get one. He's come over here for the payday, but I've got to say, Reg, a little bit disappointed. Okay, he got hit with a couple of decent shots, but those punches were not knockout punches. As he landed on the floor for the finishing punch, he was rubbing his eye as though he was feeling a little bit of discomfort, but in no way was he knocked out. He decided not to come back up again. Okay, the way it looked, Bruno was going to knock him out anyway, but we'll have to say a little bit disappointed in his lack of appetite.
Yeah, well, heavyweight fights, we know there's loads of one-rounders over the years, Jim, but we were hoping his last fight, remember, also ended in a very heavily criticised fight with Jesse Ferguson in Birmingham. And I would have thought even old Frank would have wanted to go a few rounds more, but he doesn't know how to pull punches. He unloads a little bit. As you say, I didn't like the way he was sort of protecting his eyes. Let's have a look at it again.
Well, Bruno's jab was working well right from the first bell. He got through with a couple of... And he really has a powerful jab that can sicken opponents, but it shouldn't sicken you after a couple. And that was a punch that landed a little bit high. And what a fair bit of power in the punch. It caught him high in the head, but not a knockout punch. He got back up again, as you can see. In decent shape, Bruno let go with a left hook, which again was a half-decent punch. Now, that was at the right hand again, causing the first knockdown there.
That was the first knockdown, yeah.
Not in any great deal of discomfort there. Decent punch, knocked him off balance. Again, a good jab. The jab worked well for the few seconds the fight lasted. And then he seemed to come round, it looked like a left hook. Yeah. Just a jolting hook, but no way, Reg, was that a knockout punch. He's looking down here, he knows exactly where he is, and he's decided he's where he wants to be.
Yeah, he came here and talked a good fight to Marine, I must say. And I thought he might go a few rounds, but, you know, you can never see him really winning the fight.
That was a jolting punch, that one, Reg, but no way a knockout punch. Marine found himself on the floor and really decided to stay there.
Frank will say, well, that was quicker than Riddick Bowe could do with this fella. So as we watch there, just the final punches.
I mean, once again, Big Frank did his job. So you can't fault Big Frank, but unfortunately the opponent failed to do his.
So it's goodbye Harry and come in Gary.
Just hope that Frank remembers it's Gary and not Harry.
Yeah, Harry's at home, I think.
Now, Jim Watt has just said, you won't have heard this, Frank, that you did your job. Yeah. It's not your fault that the opponent didn't do his. He was a poor opponent.
It's difficult to say he was a poor opponent because he took Joe Hip 10 rounds, yeah? About 2 months ago. Yeah, and I thought he won against Joe Hip. So I don't think he was a poor opponent. I didn't give him a chance to be a good opponent. I hit him with a jab and I was catching with left hooks and right hands. So I don't think he was a poor opponent. If you was in there taking the punches, you know what I mean? I don't think you'd be saying the same thing. Or Jim Watt would be saying the same thing. But it's all right for him to sit down there and criticise.
Yeah. We're not criticising you, Frank, yeah. And it's not our job to be fighters.
Opponent, because look at his record and see that Joe Hip is rated number 3 by the WBC, so don't you know what I mean, slag him down.
No, but you'll understand our viewers. Looking forward to seeing you. You look brilliant, you're top of the form, and they see an opponent go down so quickly.
Yeah, but with the power I've got in my hands, I'm weighing the heaviest I've ever weighed, you know what I mean? And I don't think he came over here. He's got a little bit of pride, you know? I don't think he came here to sit down, but he was tasting the jab, and he weren't no phony punches what hit him. They were hard, solid, good punches. You can see by him, he's still shaking, you know?
Okay, well, let explain to us about how hard these punches were, Frank.
No problem. I was trying to feed
my way
in, yeah. I was trying to feed my way. That's a good jab on the side of the head there. That was the top of the head. Top of the head. And he went down.
This is the last one.
Yeah.
Now, while we're talking, unfortunately, the crowd are all singing, what a load of rubbish, Frank.
Yeah, it's easy.
No, I've just let Frank finish, sorry.
Yeah, well, you know what I mean? I don't think they're shouting at me. I think they're shouting at Marion. But, you know what I mean? I'm going there to train for 10 hard rounds. If it comes to the bonus, you know?
Do you wish you'd gone longer yourself?
To be quite honest, it would have been nice for me to go longer, but I've done 150 rounds, you know what I mean, in Lanzarote, at Club La Zanta, with 3 different sparring partners. So, you know, I've got a world title fight coming up hopefully in the summer. So, you know, I don't want no mistakes to happen.
Last question before I talk to your new promoter. No. I mean, obviously, the sooner we can get Oliver McCall on, the better.
Very, very much so. I can't wait for that fight. You know, I didn't want nothing slipping up tonight. And I had to go in there and do a good number. I see him fight Joe Hoop, who's rated number 3, and I thought he beat him. So I couldn't mess around because he comes stronger and later rounds, Gary.
All right, Frank. Hope it's longer next time. Thank you. Nice. Frank Warren. You had a lot of difficulty, you said just a few minutes ago, because that didn't last very long. You had great difficulty in finding an opponent. That opponent was poor, and no one's going to be convinced any different.
I'm not trying to convince anyone. All I'll say is you look very apprehensive to start, but he looks apprehensive in his fight against Hip in the last fight. And obviously he didn't give him a chance to get into the fight at all. You know, it is very difficult, and when guys are big punchers, if they connect, they go. I've got a reputation for delivering good fights, and I've always delivered, I think, 90% of the time decent fights. You know, and as I say, it's been very difficult to find the punch, but he'd done the job and got rid of his man.
Okay, great to have Bruno on ITV. How quickly can we get Oliver McCall and the world title on? Forget about tonight and get that on.
We're working on it very hard now. Oliver McCall's got a little job to do himself first on April the 8th against Larry Holmes. And provided, you know, or the winner of that, whoever comes through, then we'll put the fight on. But let's get that one out of the way first of all.
Okay, let's hear the official verdict now from the Master of Ceremonies, Mike Goodall.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 1 minute and 5 seconds of the first round, Rudolfo Marin has failed to beat the count. The winner by count out, Frank Bruno!
So then, 65 seconds it lasted. I have to say up here I've got a bit of sympathy with Bruno. In many ways he was in a no-win scenario here tonight. If he got his opponent out of the way very quickly, the crowd around here would chant, what a load of money, you at home, or what a waste of money I should say, you at home might feel a little bit cheated. Bruno himself might have preferred the fight to go a bit longer, but his victory really was all that mattered here tonight to Frank Bruno anyway. Barry McGuigan, before the fight, you had certain misjudgments, I know, or misgivings about Frank's opponent, but you can't criticise Frank Bruno for getting in there, getting the job done and doing what he had to do.
Well, he is, as you said, Jim, in a no-win situation. He's so heavy-handed when he hits these guys, whatever little bit of desire they have goes out of them completely. and there's no doubt that he's very heavy-handed. And, you know, OK, Rodolfo Marin didn't put up much of a challenge here tonight, but all he needed was a little bit of target practice. He may have another fight, and then, of course, he hopes to get in and fight for the world title for a fourth fight, for a fourth time, and that's the one that he really wants.
That's right.
And that's the one that the general public really wants to see, too.
I would think the crowd here have been terrific, haven't they? They've filled the place out, and there must be certain sympathy for people who have paid a lot of very good money and not had too much entertainment.
Well, I'm sure they're very disappointed and they've been shouting some vulgar remarks behind me here. But nonetheless, they're still tremendous fans of Frank's, and that's the bottom line. And when he comes to fight for the title again, and hopefully he will, there'll be 40,000 people turn out to see him, you know.
That's right. What about Frank? I mean, how's he going to feel? I went over to see him over there in Lanzarote, 150 rounds, miles and miles on the roads. He comes here, and it's all over. I mean, he could fight tomorrow if he had to.
Well, absolutely.
He?
I mean, that's of no benefit to him whatsoever. I mean, a good sparring session is more is better target practice than that. And obviously, he would much prefer the fight to go into the later rounds. I think he should try and squeeze in another fight here, because really and truly, that's of no benefit to him at all. He needs four or five rounds under his belt. And he really needs a serious contender that will give him a difficult challenge for at least four or five competitive rounds where he can get real competitive action and get competition sharpness again, because that's what he needs to.
You see, would you fear for him, Barry, if you know, he went in against a McCall or a Larry Holmes, and he's had, what, two rounds in about the last year and a half?
Well, this is it. You see, if he gets a shot at the title again, and they're talking about possibly the end of the summer, he needs another fight in the meantime.
Okay.
He needs somebody that will give him a good test.
Let's get back down to ringside, back down to Gary.
Thank you, Jim. Down here with me, Emmanuel Stewart, one of the great trainers in the game, I promise you that. He had Oliver McCall, he helped him, and now he's with Lennox Lewis. Many other great names, including Gerald McClellan. Now, I think I gave Frank Bruno a harder time than his opponent, trying to get him to admit that the opponent wasn't any good. What was your opinion of the opponent?
Well, I saw him sweating while he was talking to you, and I was wondering, where did the sweat come from? It must have been from nervousness getting into the ring, because he didn't work up a sweat during the fight. You know, it's fighters like this is why people ask me in the past why I never dealt with heavyweights. I've always said the biggest problem with most heavyweights were they didn't have much courage. And after dealing with the fighters such as Thomas Hearns and Gerald McClellan and Dennis Andres and even my present boxer, Ola Clemson, at the Kronk Gym, we're used to guys who have a lot of heart. This type of a guy that fought tonight could not have even been able to be admitted to shadow box in our gymnasium. I mean, he didn't get hit with a solid punch, and I felt that Bruno and the public was all deprived of what should have been a decent fight. I felt that once he felt Bruno's strength, he just immediately gave up, and any punch that was even glancing, he just went down. He just really didn't want to fight. He didn't have the heart. I don't think it was nothing that Bruno did that should.
Bruno wants decent opponents. Bruno, how will he get on against McCall?
Bruno and McCall, I think that McCall is physically and mentally too strong a man. That's my personal opinion. McCall is a good fighter, but more than that, he's a very strong, determined person, and I don't think that Bruno could beat him. That's my opinion, but it would be a much better fight than what we saw tonight. The biggest problem seems to be Bruno himself. As the fight's progress, he seems to lose confidence in himself, even when he's winning fights. Most of the fights that he's lost, he was winning the fight, so at least he was into the fight, and it wasn't so much what an opponent did. It seems like, to me, it's like at a certain point he realized he was winning, and then he lost confidence himself.
Emmanuel, thank you very much indeed. There's no doubt, though, Jim Rosenthal, that they do love Frank Bruno. Let's hope he gets a better opponent next time.
Yes, they do love him, Emmanuel Stewart, of course, looking after Lennox Lewis these days, and, well, his criticism of Frank Bruno, not totally unexpected there. A brief fight for you this week. Next Saturday night, we're back at 9 o'clock, and it should be an absolutely outstanding fight, that one. Two explosive fighters. Nigel Benn, the British champion, British super middleweight champion, defending his title against a fearsome hitter called Gerald McClellan. Throughout his career, Ben's always loved a good old tear-up. Next Saturday, he goes in with one of the hardest hitters of modern times. Ben, though, has seen it all.
the challenger, Gerald McClelland, the G-man. He's never been beyond eight, and his record is quite astonishing. 28 wins inside three rounds.
Ooh, nice shot by Julian.
As he goes upstairs, no chance to south. Oh, there. Julian gonna win already. Down goes Jackson.
Julian Jackson, and he is the new WBC middleweight champion.
Gilbert Baptiste didn't last too long either. Making middleweight for this one was pure agony for McClelland, but you'd never have guessed. Another quality opponent blown away in the first round. Rematch with Jackson was brief and brutal. McClelland's 20th first round triumph.
What a fearsome character. Just let me tell you, in a few minutes time I'll have a competition for you. You can win a couple of tickets, £1,000 if you prefer, but two tickets and a VIP trip to that fight next week, Ben against McClelland. Well, Nigel Benn has stayed over at his training base in Tenerife. He's been very elusive, he's kept quiet, but McClelland is here in London. He's been working out at the Peacock Gym in East London, and he's been drawing rave reviews there, I can tell you. Well, Gary Newbon caught up with him yesterday and asked McClelland for his views on Nigel Benn.
Well, I think Ben has been a great champion. He's got to be somebody. He has a super middleweight title. And as far as in the ring with me against an opponent like Ben, I don't think I should have no problem. I won't have a problem with him. It's a perfect style. He's a guy that's going to come towards me. He has a lot of heart. He thinks he's a big puncher, so that's going to be tailor-made for me.
You've never been past eight rounds.
No. I will never go past eight rounds again. My fights don't go that long. I mean, the way I train and the way I punch, and the heart I got and the mind I have, my fights probably will never go past two or three rounds.
Unlike a lot of fighters, though, Ben is never afraid to go in with anybody. He's been in with Ira and Barclay, and that was a tremendous one-round fight that he won. He may be a little bit tougher than some of the opponents you met.
Well, believe it or not, Barclay was a hard puncher, but, you know, you got to have speed and power to make a great punch. You know, Barclay punches were very hard. You know, you can see him coming. The punches that knock you out is the ones you don't see coming, so I had the speed and power. And you can't compare me now with the other fights that I had before, because I was, like, killing myself to make weight, and then people said I don't have no stamina. I mean, if you lose 11 pounds the day before the fight, and you'd be exhausted too. So this is the first fight that I'm in the ring with all my strength. I'll be weighing like 175, my natural walk-around weight, without losing any weight, and this is as strong as I ever be in a fight.
You got a tremendous left hook. You got some tremendous range of punches. How long do you think this fight will go?
It depends on Ben. You know, if he sit there and challenge me, then it'd be over quick. But if he take his time and try to outbox me and move a little bit, then it'd probably take me a little longer to catch up with him, but not too many rounds.
What do you think of his punching, pal?
Well, I mean, he has about 85-90% knockout ratio. He's punching pretty good. I never gave my opponent enough credit. I never gave none of my opponents credit for being a big knockout artist, because mentally, if you go in the ring thinking this guy's a big puncher, this guy's a better boxer than me, mentally you beat. So I look at all my opponents as sparring partner.
What are your strengths, do you think?
Boxing, punching, I can do it all.
Are there any weaknesses there?
No, just me.
Outside the ring, you've got an interest in the fact you've got four pit bull terriers. One would frighten most people.
Right, I mean, I just have pit bulls, because pit bull is the only dog that remind me of myself, you know, just real aggressive, don't take none off nobody, and just straight to the point, and it's a real aggressive dog.
And he's a very aggressive man as well. 9 o'clock, same place, same time, Saturday night. It could well be one of the great fights of the year, that one, Nigel Benn against Gerald McClelland. Well, Frank Bruno took just 65 seconds to get the job done here tonight. Barry McGuigan, are you expecting another pretty quick one at the Arena, London Arena, next Saturday?
Well, I have to tell you, this is, in the trade, And any boxing fan will tell you this is the most anticipated fight and look forward to fight that we've had for 10 years. This guy McClelland is absolutely remarkable, and the bill itself is a remarkable bill. Two world title fights and a fabulous undercard. I can't wait for it to happen. It's going to be exciting, however long it lasts.
It will be.
And I'll tell you, it's going to be a remarkable fight. And if anybody out there thinking of buying a ticket, go and get one. It's going to be a fabulous fight.
That's right. Well, of course, if you can't get there, be with us at 9 o'clock on ITV. Just quickly, Barry, they've made McClelland the odds-on favourite. Does that surprise you?
No, it doesn't surprise me. This guy's an awesome puncher. 20 first-round knockouts. He's an incredible puncher, and this could be the end of Nigel next Saturday, and I hope I'm wrong, but he's